Hi everyone, in this session we are going to solve some numericals based on moment of force and pressure. Let's write the equation first. What's the equation to find out moment of force? Moment of force is equal to force into perpendicular distance. And the equation to find out pressure? Pressure is equal to thrust divided by area. So here we are using these two equations to solve the numericals. Let's see the first question. In the first question, force is given as 20 Newton and the perpendicular distance is given as 0.5 meter. We have to find out the moment of force. It's very easy to find it out, right? No? We have to use the equation M is equal to force into distance, that's equal to 20 into 0.5. What will you get? We will get it as 10. What is the unit of moment of force? Newton meter. Okay, so this is the first answer. Let's see the second question. In the second question, the force and moment of force is given. We have to find out the perpendicular distance. Force is given as 25 Newton and moment of force is given as 2.5 Newton meter. We have to find out the distance. Okay, we'll use the same equation. Moment of force is equal to force into distance. We'll substitute the value and we will rearrange it. Or we have to find this D as an unknown factor. So we'll keep D in one side and we'll make the other factors to other side. So here D is equal to moment of force divided by force. Right? No? So it's equal to 2.5 divided by 25. 2.5 divided by 25. If we solve it, we will get it as 0.5 1 meter. What is 0.1 meter? That is equivalent to 10 centimeters. Any value you can write it. 0.1 meter or 10 centimeters. So here we are just rearranging the equation. So write down the data as find or substitute in the value and keep the unknown factor in one side. Rearrange it and find the answer with proper unit. Let's see the third question. For third question, it's related with pressure. So here, the thrust is given as 200 Newton and the area is given as 0.02 meter square. We have to find out the pressure. What's the equation to find out the pressure? Pressure is equal to thrust by area. We just want to substitute the values in this equation. It's 200 divided by 0.02. Now can we take out this decimal point? We have to multiply by 100. Here also 100, right? So we will get it as 1000 divided by 2, that is equal to 10,000 pascals. The unit of pressure is Newton per meter square or Pascal. Let's see the fourth question. In the fourth question, the pressure is given as 50,000 Pascal and the area is equal to 0.05 meter square. We have to find the thrust. Same equation, P is equal to T by A. We are rearranging the equations cross multiplication. So thrust is equal to pressure into area. Substitute the value 50,000 into 0.05. So after that, after the calculation, we will get it as 2500 Newton. So just want to substitute, rearrange the equation and find out the answer with proper unit. Let's see the next question. Fifth question, little tricky because it's given the data in terms of centimeter, that we have to convert it into meter. So the thrust is given as 300 newton and area of cross section is given as 30 centimeter square. Okay, we will substitute the value. Pressure is equal to thrust by area. What is thrust? Thrust is equal to 300 divided by 30. How can we convert centimeter to meter, smaller value to bigger value? So divide by 100, right? Then centimeter square to meter square, divide by 1 by 100 square, right? No, or else we can write it as 1 by 10 to the power 4. 100 square, right? 100 is equal to 10 to the power 2, again square, 10 to the power 4. So here we are going to use it that. So we will write it here as 1 divided by 10 to the power 4. Okay, so what happens? This factor will go up. So we will get it as 300 into 10 to the power 4 divided by 30. 30 by 3 is 10 into 10 to the power 4, or that is we can write it as 10 to the power 5 pascal. Okay, so wherever you will get centimeter, convert that into meter by dividing. If it is 30, 30 into 10 to the power minus 4. Okay, so you have to use this to convert it into centimeter to meter. Then you substitute the values and find out the value in proper unit. And area is not given in SI unit. You don't want to worry about that. You can directly do it as in the CGS unit. So let's see the next problem. A sixth problem. The thrust is given as 100 kilogram force in terms of weight and the area is given as 0.5 meter square. We'll apply the equation. We have to find out the pressure. Okay, so pressure is equal to thrust divided by area. So 100 divided by 0.5. We will clear out this decimal point. So 1000 divided by 5, that is equal to 200 kilogram force divided by meter square. Okay, so here the data is given in terms of kilogram force. Now how can we convert kilogram force into newton? We studied that 1 kilogram force is equal to 10 newton. No issue, you can write this as the answer. If you want to convert, particularly if it is mentioned in the question that you have to convert it into pascal, again, you have to convert or multiply by 10. What you will get? You will get 2000 newton per meter square. So, this is the way how we have to calculate the answer with proper unit. Let's see the last problem. So, in our seventh question, the thrust is given as 2 kilogram force, and instead of the area, it's given a dimension. Dimension is given as 20 centimeter into 10 centimeter into 5 centimeter. So it's a three-dimensional object. We have to find the three different cases. If we keep the object in three different ways, how the pressure will act. Just see that this is a box. Okay, consider this length as 20 centimeter, this has 10 centimeter and this has 5 centimeter. So first case, we have to find out the pressure acting on 20 and 10. That means if we keep the object like this way, how much pressure it exert. Okay, we will make it as three case. First case, the dimension 20 centimeter into 10 centimeter. Okay, so pressure is equal to pressure, the thrust will not change, right? So T by A, which is equal to 2 kilogram force divided by foot's area. How to find out area if the length and breadth is given? Length into breadth. 20 into 10. 20 into 10. Right? No? That's equal to 2 divided by 200 we'll get. 2 divided by 200. That is equal to 0.01 kilogram force per centimeter square. Okay, that's the first case. I will go to the second one. We will consider it as 20 centimeter and 5 centimeter. That means 20 centimeter and 5 centimeter, the object has to keep like this way, how much pressure it exerts. So we will find out pressure is equal to thrust by area, that's equal to same thrust, 2 divided by 20 into 5. That's equal to 2 by 100. What is 2 by 100? It's equal to 0.02 kilogram force per centimeter square. That's our second pressure, second answer. Now we'll see the third one. What's the third one? Third option, 10 centimeter into 5 centimeter. Okay, 10 centimeter into 5 centimeter. That means 10 into 5. This is the position, how much pressure it will exert. Okay, so pressure is equal to thrust by area, that's equal to 2 divided by 10 into 5. Okay, so it's equal to 2 by 50. It is equal to 0.04 kilogram force by centimeter square. So these are our three keys when the pressure acts on three different positions. First we found in this position how the pressure will be acting. Second we found if we keep the object like this way. And finally we found the pressure acting on this area. So here it's not particularly mentioned to convert it into Pascal, so you can write it like this way, both given in CGS unit, kilogram force and centimeter square, then no need to convert it. Practice more problems by own. Thank you.